My father was Lieutenant Colonel David S. Greene. He was a helicopter pilot for the Marine Corps. He flew Cobras. My name is Jenna Greene, and I work as a reporter for both the Smoke Room and the Daily Caller. It's funny, when I think about my father, I don't necessarily remember him as this like big, bad Marine. Of course, I knew he was always protective and took my family's safety very seriously, but the memories that I have of him are far softer. I can remember throwing a baseball with him in the backyard and waiting for him to come home. My last memory of being with him, I had a terrible stomach bug. I couldn't even get up off the couch to hug him goodbye. But he knew that my family was so proud of him, and he knew how much I loved him, and that was all that mattered. A lone sniper's bullet entered the Cobra, the window of the helicopter that he was flying, and gave him a fatal shot in the back of his neck. He was killed instantly, and he to this day remains one of the highest ranking Marines to be killed in Iraq since 2003. I received a phone call from my mom on speaker with my brother, and she asked me if I was sitting down. And I promptly sat down, and she said, "We're going to meet the president this weekend. He's going to give a speech in Arlington, and he wants to honor your father, and he wants to tell our story." 14 years out, and I still obviously mourn my father's loss, but I'm at the point where I'm prouder of what he did than, you know, sad about it. And so I was so excited.
Most importantly, we're joined today by the families of American heroes who made the ultimate sacrifice. Joining us today is the family of Marine Lieutenant Colonel David Greene, who rests here at Arlington. He's looking down on you, and he's so proud and happy.
I'm so used to seeing Donald Trump and hearing his name and hearing his voice and, you know, playing news clips of him. It didn't hit me until I heard him say my name. And that's kind of when it all just focused.
Their two beautiful children, Jenna and Wesley.
I had an opportunity to meet the president after he gave his speech, and that was surreal as well. A lot of people like to give Trump flack. I think that's kind of putting it lightly. But he was one of the most personable and genuine people I think I've probably ever encountered.
But for him, it was never about rank or title. Like all of his fellow warriors, it was only about duty. He served to defend our flag and our freedom.
To just kind of like see the tears in the eyes of so many people that I recognize from television and even report on a daily basis, that was an incredible feeling. And it made me feel like, you know, my father's sacrifice was not in vain. And there are so many incredible people in the cabinet right now and across the nation that are thankful for what my father and so many other people have done. And it's truly a sensational feeling.